Welcome back to He-Man Plot Holes, and today we're taking a special close look at the Shaping Staff. There's two plot holes to this episode which have always bothered me, and today we're going to discuss them. So, this is the episode, of course, in which Evil-Lyn uses the Shaping Staff to transform herself and Beast-Man into an enchantress and King Randor to fool the heroes. Eventually, they also transform Orko, Teela, the Sorceress, and He-Man as well. And for He-Man toy fans, this is also remembered as the really lackluster and only appearance of Faker on the Filmation He-Man show. So the two plot holes in this episode really have to do with the staff itself and the episode's finale. Firstly, I've mentioned the Shaping Staff in a prior He-Man plot holes video when King Randor bizarrely calls the staff just a myth.
But the Shaping Staff is just a myth, a fairy tale.
Which of course, in a series full of magical creatures and heroes, makes absolutely no sense. But moreover, the thing that bothers me about the staff is really, why does Evil-Lyn need the staff in the first place? It's implied the staff allows her to transform, but we've seen in several episodes that she can transform without trouble herself. She does this in The Curse of the Spellstone and Evil-Lyn's plot, just to name two examples of many. Now, of course, a big plot point is how Evil-Lyn also uses the staff to transform others. So that, at first, came to my mind as the special aspect of the staff, but then I remembered episodes like The Creatures from the Jar Swamp, or The Witch and the Warrior, where Evil-Lyn transforms other characters without difficulty. So that makes no sense either. In fact, at the end, Evil-Lyn herself is accidentally transformed, but Skeletor swears to restore her and Faker, as well as come back for revenge. Now to me, it's kinda obvious what happened from a meta point of view. It seems Filmation's writers really liked Evil-Lyn's transformation ability, and so decided that rather than have it be a one-off element of the show, they'd just turn this into a regular ability of hers. If we're thinking story-wise, it also kinda makes a little bit of sense. Maybe some of the staff's power gets transferred to Evil-Lyn when she tries to use the broken staff and turns into this winged worm thingy. That's a theory that I could honestly get behind. Now, as for Faker, the main thing that makes him kinda sucky is how he's not even blue the way he was originally. Ironically, he's actually a more convincing looking He-Man lookalike, except with glowing eyes and a robotic voice. Now, at the end of the episode, Faker falls into the Pit of Grayskull, and as I mentioned before, Skeletor swears to not just restore Evil-Lyn, but Faker as well. However, as you might remember, this is Faker's only appearance on the show, meaning that while Skelly fulfilled his promise to Evil-Lyn, he didn't do it for Faker. So why is that? Well, maybe because Faker was a terrible character and Filmation didn't want to use him at all. But also, Faker sort of proposes another plot hole. Why is he a match for He-Man? He-Man's power derives from Castle Grayskull, but Skeletor literally just whips Faker into existence out of thin air.
I will make another He-Man, an evil one called Faker. I have done it!
I mean, maybe he used so much power that time that he just couldn't do it again, but still, there really is no explanation for this. Another more broader question is why both he and Faker make references to He-Man's transformation call, since, you know, neither of these characters should even be aware of it.
I have your power too!
Now I have the power!
The world may never know. And that's all from me for this time. I'm Hanno the Hanomakinen. I have the power, so can you.